As it's getting darker earlier, it's a great opportunity to see more of the night sky, and September is a great time to spot Jupiter. So why not try some stargazing? Ricky's been getting some awesome astronomy tips from Ezzy Pearson from Sky at Night magazine.
So for someone who maybe doesn't know what they're doing, what top tips would you give to be successful at stargazing at night?
First of all, be prepared. Make sure that you stay warm. You also want to make sure that you're somewhere safe and somewhere that you're allowed to be. Get away from artificial light. So that's things like street lights, your house lights, your phone. Even if it's just you're standing in that one corner of your garden that isn't directly underneath the streetlight, that will really help. Give your eyes a bit of time to adjust to the darkness. You might have noticed that when you're going to bed at night, when you first turn out the light, you can't see anything. And then after a couple of minutes, you can start seeing, you know, your desk and your pile of clothes on the floor. That's because your eyes get more adapted to the dark as time goes on. For me, the thing that really started my love with space and the night sky was when I was on holiday down in Cornwall. And it was the first time I'd ever really been away from lights and away from light pollution. And I looked up and I saw the Milky Way, which is this incredible band of stars. There's so many, you can't even tell individual stars anymore. They all blend in together. And that was absolutely stunning. And that's always been my favorite memory.